In LA, a new rap style was emerging. Gangster rap brought together the imagery of blaxploitation movies with the gang cultures of the West Coast. Ultra violent, pimp, hustler, player, criminal, and in your face.
Straight out of Compton, it's a crazy brother named Ice Cube. From the stupid dope gang with an attitude. When I'm caught off, I got a sword off. Kick knowledge and bodies all hauled off. Yo, Trey, what's the sound of my tool? Now you know that I'm about to act a fool. So when I'm in your neighborhood, you better duck down. Cause Ice Cube, a damn show, f*** him down. As I leave, believe I'm stomping. But when I come back, boy, I'm coming straight out of Compton.
Compton, Compton, Compton.
I don't know which writer is the one who called it gangster rap. You know, I still call it reality rap, you know, because, you know, our stuff is much more than just talking about gangster things. Our stuff is talking about the social climate. So, to me, it means a network of information.
Well, you know, you had gangster records or gangster or criminal-minded records, to use that phrase, from KRS-One and some from New York beforehand. But when N.W.A. came out, was Straight Outta Compton. They just, you know, blew the doors open.
Easy as his name and the boys coming.
Straight Outta Compton. It's a brother that'll smother your mother and make your sister think I love her. Dangerous young brother racing hell.
And people think, oh, Compton, yeah, if you're from Compton, you're this bad, tough guy.
I don't think it's a true picture. I think, again, it's something that they've taken and exploited. Anyway, to sell music and make money. And of course, and I'm not saying that there isn't violence, that there isn't gang activity, we do have that, but not at the levels that, of course, that the gangster rappers project this community to have. Again, some of these individuals may or may not even be gang members.
N.W.A. didn't give Compton the reputation. Compton gave Compton the reputation. The rap music is safe compared to day-to-day living, just being, it's so frustrating because it's so unpredictable. And it's nothing, it's not like we're bad people, but it's just poverty brings on these type of actions and brings out these type of individual. It brings out the worst in you. Because, you know, if you got a pack of hungry lions, you throw one steak, and they're gonna fight over that one steak, and that's all we got out here. If that, you know, one half a steak, if that. So you got people fighting over crumbs, you know, because we hungry and we frustrated. Poverty is all through our neighborhoods, and we got opposition.
And I was born and raised here, and you know, I resent it. And again, it's not reflective of the vast majority of people in this community who suffer through this image thing that has, I mean, really, really some prolonged impact on our ability to attract business, maintain positive citizens in this community.
Plus, nobody I know got killed in South Central LA. Today was a good day. As hell, but no throwing up. Halfway home, man, my page is still blowing up. Today I didn't even have to use my AK. I gotta say it was a good day.
When you have Ice Cube executing a very well thought out lyric with excellent production, it rises above the genre. When you have some kid who's got minimal skills and just wants to tell a gory story over a really whack beat, you have a crappy record. So I think for the most part, most gangster rap records are not artistically justified. I think they just exist as a way to make money. In the same way that so many Hollywood action movies exist in the same way. A good gangster rap record is like a good action movie. It's pulp.
Come from the depths of the sea. Back to the block, Snoop Doggy Dog, funky as the doc. Went solo on that ass, but it's still the same. Long Beach is the spot where I serve my cane. Follow me, but you bet not slip, cause 9 Triz ain't the year there for me to clizz out my grip. So I ain't holding nothing back, and once again I got 5 on the 20 sack. It's like that, and as a matter of fact, cause I never hesitate to put a fool on his back.
Yeah, so keep out the manuscript. You see that it's a must, we drop gangsta.
Hold up, what's my name?
We've been opposed to the negative lyrics in some rap music because those lyrics are demeaning to human beings generally, especially to women. They're homophobic, they're sexist, they're racist, and they engender violence. If not engender it, they at least exacerbate it. All of this really is non-redemptive. It's not helpful. It's no social commentary whatsoever.
Death is something that's always on my mind because death comes so sudden to young black males. I don't know anybody that planned to die. You know, I got a line in my record, It's a Good Day, saying I'm out the dope, thinking will I live another 24.
Hooked it up for later as I hit the dope, thinking will I live another 24. I gotta go cause I got me a drop top, and if I hit the switch, I can make the ass drop.
So just living another 24 hours is my focus. You can't really plan on what you're gonna do next month or this month. It's just getting through the day, making sure you stay out of people's way who are fools who will take your life. So, you know, that's constantly on my mind.
And I'm troubled. Last week, messed around and got a triple-double. Freaking brothers every way like MJ. I can't believe today was a good day.
My half-sister was killed. One of my friends, T-Bone, was killed. Another of my friends, David, was killed. A guy named Bird. You can just count them. A couple of guys from my classes. Countless number of guys from my neighborhood. Didn't live at 24.
I am concerned when so many of our young men and women are being killed by each other. I am concerned when there's so much looting and stealing and mugging in our communities that people would talk against the police when the police are, in fact, helpful in many instances in helping to curb crime. So there are some borders across which we should not venture. And some of our rappers are just randomly advocating violence, which I think is not helpful.
We have not always conducted ourselves the way we should. I mean, you know, as an occupation, and as police officers, as law enforcement officers. And of course, some people again see us as being the very thing that's symbolic of oppressing them and things that they hate, and we're the easiest thing to reach out at.
Do you swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth? So help your black ass. You goddamn right. Won't you tell everybody what the you gotta say?
Coming straight from the underground. A young nigga got it bad cause I'm brown. And not the other color, so police think they have the authority to kill a minority. That shit cause I ain't the one for a punk with a badge and a gun to be beaten on. And thrown in jail, we can go toe to toe in the middle of a cell. With me cause I'm a teenager with a little bit of gold and a pager. Searching my car, looking for the product. Every nigga is selling narcotics.
The beating of Rodney King by several Los Angeles police officers led to the LA insurrection of 1992. The worst riots America had seen in 25 years.
The LA riot was started by the most famous police brutality case of all time. So I think that rappers articulated a lot of the concerns of the black community And certainly in L.A.'s particularly, the police's relationship to the black community had always been very adversary. There was very little outreach, very little sense of trying to patrol friendly in a friendly sense. There was always a sense that we are controlling an armed camp and we will use whatever force necessary. That was the philosophy, to keep these black people in check.
It wasn't nothing but frustration and poverty just met at the same spot and blew up. What you expect? It meant that, you know, it meant to me that we wasn't dead. You know, because, I mean, America handles all her problems violently. All of them. She rarely talks about, you know, she ready to shoot, send troops. You know, for the citizens of America to do the same thing, what'd you expect? We got hurt, definitely.
After the April 92 riots, our two gangs, Crips and Bloods, got together and decided to cease the, you know, their hostilities toward each other. In this community, it really, really had a positive impact because of our number of gang-related crimes, especially involving these two groups, of course, diminished fantastically. Last year, we had a 30% decrease in homicides, for instance.
Listen to the radio, and you hear a lot of white people talk about how they victims now. They're being discriminated against, and you know, it's like, it's kind of funny because the things that they've set out are coming back.
Unlike a lot of people, I don't necessarily think that these gangster rap records are the reason that X, Y, and Z exist in the black community or violence exists in America. I think the antecedents of violence in America have more to do with the influx of drugs and guns than have to do with any individual records.